Yeah, picking up a scout here in West Texas. Finally got a load. Been damn near 10 days, man. This all feel ridiculous, but I'm already making plans to get away from it, man. Go back driving tankers. But in the meanwhile, how y'all doing, man? I'm out here on my way back home, back to the H. Coming from my trip to West Texas. It's been a good one. I lucked up and got we have a terminal in West Texas, so I called dispatch, see what they had going on out there, and I looked up and I didn't have a back it up a second. I didn't have a back haul at the rig. It was like a startup job. So I got on the phone and called my dispatch and told them what was up and see what they had baking them, you know, in West Texas that I make a grab up. And got lucky. Grabbed a little load from a rig, another rig, and turned out to be good. So you know, had three stops on it. So I knocked that out and took me a break, 10-hour break. I was tired, so I've been up. The one thing in this business, sometimes you don't know when you're gonna get a load by being so slow. I've been up all day, exercise, everything, and right when you think, oh well, probably not gonna be the day, they call, you know, 9:30 at night. So I rolled out here, out of my business, did a load, made it back as far as I could on my log, and laid it down. Now it's 4 o'clock in the morning. See where I'm at. I'm in Mingus, Texas. Probably on the outskirts of Fort Worth. And stuff is out here. Like 25 degrees out here, man. Boy, you do them tie checks and load checks, man. Getting cold out here, you know. We're southern, baby, but I do the snow. You know, I like seeing all seasons and stuff. I wouldn't mind living somewhere where I could see it. I know in that wintertime, it's a lot of work. I see people shoveling that snow. Man, I done had to do it before. One time I was in, I got caught in a blizzard in Baltimore when they had the Super Bowl with New Orleans won, New Orleans Saints won. Whatever year that is, I don't keep up with it. But man, I got snowed in and couldn't even see the vehicles. Man, I'm about to post some pictures of that. My whole truck was covered up, man. And I asked the lady at the desk, I said, hey, y'all got somebody that's gonna clean out the parking lot and stuff like that? Oh yeah, sure. And what actually they did is cleaned out everywhere that the normal people park and pushed all that stuff to the parking where the big trucks was. I'm talking about some work, man. Woo! Backbreaking work. That was a memorable day though. I ate some what they call that, frozen chicken. So I had to walk to a grocery store and do some kind of doge chicken, or broge, some kind of chicken, banquet chicken. Crazy, watching the hotel, watching the Saints. Who that? Yeah, but I'm just rolling along. Should probably get home probably about 8:30, 9 o'clock in the morning. I'm planning on stopping wake up morning, take a 30-minute break. That's it. Keep my foot on the pedal. Man, you gotta keep these doors closed when you're rolling, man. Every truck stop and stuff, you can't be stopping, man. When you make a stop, make it count. You know, I got a Yeti cup, it pretty much hold ice all day, but if I stop, I refresh it up, I top it off. You know, I keep me at least a couple gallons of water in here. You know, I got all my little snacks and little food and stuff. So when I make a stop, I make it count. You know, if I need to use the restroom, whatever I need to do, I get it all over and make it count within that little time frame. So when I'm rolling, doors are closed, I'm rolling. Gotta be productive. Be productive. You know? Especially on trips like this. 650-mile trips, you got to get it, you got to roll. If you're on a time schedule, you know, if they load you, if they call you out to get loaded for a rig and they gotta go 650 miles, you know, just average. Let's say you're gonna average 60. I know you might be able to roll 70, but you're not average 60, so you're looking at 10 and a half hours to get there. So you got 14-hour window, 11 driving. So 10 and a half, that give you 3.5 play time. Really, you ain't got 3.5 because you take the pre-trip. So it's load time and a 30-minute break. So you really don't have that, you know, maybe an hour or two to play with, really. So you got to be rolling. You got to be rolling. Can't be playing, you know. Shorter runs, 250 miles, stuff like that, 500 mile a day. You know, you can actually do it. Night driving, you know. It's not good to be out here with your eyes all tired because, you know, a lot of stuff happened today. A lot of stuff happened at night. You kind of, some reason, like the deer, birds. Like I said, I hit a wild turkey, man. You know, so much stuff come out at night trying to, I guess, eat and whatever they doing. But shit. You see a lot of stuff, the wild hogs, everything, man. Your head got to stay on the swivel and really be up and paying attention to what you're doing and watching these other drivers that's trying to make it somewhere to their destination. They sleep, you know. They tired, you know. So it puts more, it requires you more, a lot more scanning vision, keeping your eyes being alert. Always keeping your space. That space is important. If you're paying attention to the nearest truck up there, I'm not sure. It has to be 10, 15 seconds ahead of me. I'm not no rush. I'm still doing 7-3 cruise set, you know, so I'm getting where I need to go. I get in, do all my paperwork, you know, scan my receipts. Pretty well, I always like to calculate the trip, total miles, cost per mile, what I did on the load after everything, you know. So this actuality, you get a backhaul or, you know, I can do a load out there, make the trip real worth it while, otherwise, it would have been just a load, you know. This turned out to be a decent, good load, especially this time with the oil field being so bad right now.
The speed limit is 70 miles per hour.
Trying to hold on, but sure as tea. But I think I'm gonna jump back on tankers. You know, I used to drive tankers for service transport for a second, you know, and I think I'm thinking about jumping back. I've been redoing my research on some of these companies. So much has changed, you know. Really got to do your research, you know. I mean, YouTube and watching a lot of people listening and taking in everything I can, man. Knowledge is king, you know. You don't slip this count. You don't want to get out here and get one of these old poor cone companies. They ain't worth nothing. Full of cone, not taking care of the equipment, not taking care of the driver. So, the money not right. When the money not right, you're really going to be sick, you know. I put over a lot of shit sometimes when the money right. Other thing too, you know. So you gotta really do your homework. Really do your homework, you know. I don't believe
the speed limit is 70 miles per hour.
That job hopping is not good at all, you know. People, they pay attention to that, you know. It costs a lot, and they go through a lot of, you know, a lot to hire personnel, you know, a lot of time and productive that they could be doing something else. So you really have to consider when you're doing that job hopping. So do your research and, you know, go with the best bet that you feel is comfortable for your situation. You know, be tackling. I'm not trying to be on the road 20 days, come home 5-6. I'm more looking for something 10-14 out, maybe. Come home 2, back rolling, you know. 7, come home a day or 2, back rolling, you know.
The speed limit is 70 miles per hour.
I have kids, family, wife, so I'm not trying to be away like that all the time, you know. Your presence is needed, you know. I know you got today technology, phone, video chat, and everything else, but your physical presence goes a long way. A long way. Set the driver temperature to 71.
Setting the driver temperature to 71 degrees.
Yeah, you know, I cap sometimes, you know. I didn't pay my dues, you know. Well, I always had a nice truck, but you know, this time I got a loaded out truck, got everything, the heated seats, cooling seats.
The speed limit is 70 miles per hour.
Sunroof, you know, the high foot engine, best transmission, stuff like that, you know, just comfort at home, 4x4, airbags, the air ride, you know, trail air, you know, trail on the tongue, air ride. So I figure if I'm gonna ride 100,000 miles a year, I wanna do it in style and I wanna do it comfortable, you know what I'm saying? I don't have no more personal vehicle. I got an old truck. I made that my personal vehicle. You know, a man need a truck. All that car stuff. You got a truck, cool. You know, ain't nothing wrong with having a car. You know, I had an old Caddy. Got rid of it. You know what I'm saying? Just kept my truck. That's all I need. Go with fishing poles, whatever I need to do. I need to go get a part for this truck, take that truck. But put it on the back, strap it down, whatever I need to do. I got a car, you can't put tires in the car, brakes and stuff like that. That's that. Just rambling though, you know. 4 o'clock in the morning. You know. Family sleep, snoring, dreaming, fighting in they sleep. And I'm out here getting it. You know what I'm saying? Bringing it on home. All good, these Saturday mornings, yeah. Get home, pull out my prep meal, food I'm gonna do for my prep meal, I'm gonna cook for the next 2-3 days on my prep meal, trying to lose this weight, keep the mind and body sharp. Always gotta be prepared. Like I say, catch up with this paperwork. do my prep meals, relax, and see what time I finish. Take me a good power nap, and it's not too cold. Me and the kids might go take a stroll at the park. Get out and kick it. YouTube. I like the YouTube. And tape stuff, come back and try to video, you know, be an editor and put it together. Something to do. All feels so slow. It might be 3-4 days, but you never know. I might get a call tomorrow. You know, hey, you ready to go to North Dakota? So always be prepared. You know, tomorrow you're gonna check out. You get home, post trip is real important. You know, check out your trailer, make sure all your lights. You know, check see if you got seal leaks. You know. All the stuff, check to see if you ain't, you know, your leaf springs, anything you can check, just pretty much do a good post trip on your truck and trailer, check all your fluids, you know. Another thing people probably don't do, I don't know, check all, you know, license and permits, you know, make sure all your insurance and everything is up to date. A lot of people get out here and don't realize something expired, you get DOT, you know. Be an ass and give you a warning or fine you, knowing you, you know, because they can always check in the system and know if you got insurance, your health, or your medical card, you have to register that stuff, which is state. So, but, you know, some of them be assholes out here, so, man, you gotta be prepared. Slippers count. I always try to tell people, slippers count out here. You know, sometimes you don't get a second chance. You go off the road, kill yourself, man. Something, you know. So no load is that important, you know. I do time-sensitive freight, you know. But, you know, that's why I try to say keep the door closed so you can keep your cushion. You know, your eyes get so heavy. And pull that sucker over. Monster drinks and five-hour drinks. That's nothing, man. Nothing beats an hour of closing that eyes, man. Lay that seat back or get your sleeper and lay it down. Get out the truck, walk around and brush your teeth. Go for water on your face. Shit, you're good to go again. Push the trip in. I'm just sharing a few pointers. It's around, like I say, rambling. I like it, a lot of scenery, see a lot of stuff, you know, and then sometimes I feel like I hate it, or just having a bad day, you know, but everybody have it. Every day not going to be a good day, but you have more good days than bad days out here, and especially when you're making some money, count miles. That's another reason I got the truck and everything that I wanted, because I wanted this want to be out here, you know, you don't want to be driving something really don't like, and you know, I get in here, put a movie on, I don't even be watching, just listen to it, or just listen to all my talk shows, and stuff like that. Big on talk shows, man, that music get old, repetitious, I guarantee you, if you listen to one station, on 45, or you know, on Sirius, J45, Backspin, any one of the stations. If you're in truck, you listen to it.
The speed limit is 70 miles per hour.
For 2-3 hours, you've heard the same song 4 or 5 times, even if you switch the channels. So, talk shows are something pretty much different all the time, you know, especially this. Talking about all these politics, oil prices, and all the stuff that be going on, the water issue in Flint, you know, some crazy stuff going on in this world, man. People got a lot to say, a lot to talk about. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna sign off, man. We'll holler later. Peace, be safe, be prosperous.